Hello everybody,
I'm Kage, and today I'm going to draw. So I have been drawing for a few years. Just a sec. So I have been drawing for a few years, but I never was actually serious about it. So now that I have some free time, I would like to dedicate myself a little bit more for So as you can see, English is not my first language. I apologize for any mistakes, but let's get to drawing. So I'm using Krita. Krita is a free software that I very much like to use. And today I'm going to draw common kitchen utensils. I think they are simple objects that will allow me to train my basic drawing skills. So if you have any questions, just ask. So let's begin. So in the left corner here, you can see what I'm using as a as a reference, and it's a simple steel pen. So let's begin. So I'm going to name this layer here sketch. And I'm going to use a blue color for the preliminary sketch. Let's go full screen. So we're going to start with the most basic shapes, and for this pen it's basically a cylinder. So let's try to draw a cylinder using the right perspective. So as you can see, the pen is behind the horizon line. It's below the horizon line. And that's why we can see the top of the pen. So let's try to get these proportions right. A little bit more. Yeah, I think that's it. So let's draw the top using a simple ellipse. and here the bottom. It's a little bit crooked, but let's continue. Let's draw here the middle line. So, more or less about here, we have the handle. It's, you can start with a single ellipsis stick too. So here we have our handle and the bottom of the pen. There's a little bit of a curve here. Yes, I think I botched the proportions. So the body of our pen, it's basically done. Let's start with the handles. So there are two handles, one is here and the other is on the other side. Let's approximate them with a rectangle for now. Try to follow the form. Here. So now I need to position this handle. On the other side, it's very important to you to think in 3D while you're drawing. So you need to be able to imagine what you can see. So here I'm going to use the first handle that I drew as a reference to try to draw, and my middle line here, to try to draw the other handle on the invisible handle on the other side. So let's go here. Yes, I think that's more or less why where it is. So let's draw in. Okay, I think that's okay for to begin. So the handle continues here. So now, the handle itself. What does this look like? It's kinda like a cookie. Squeeze a little bit. here. It's above here. So I'm trying to understand where in our nice perspective the handles are. Something like this. Yeah, kind of. A little off the focus in the picture too. That's okay. Much bigger too. Can I fix this? Yes, it's wrong here. You can see that in my picture, you can see this part of the handle, but in my drawing, it's missing. Where is my mistake? Move this to here. Kind of that's here. Yeah, not working. Let's erase some things. Forget where all the things are. Seeing this on the picture, so it should stay here. But how do I draw this handle then? Let's try to wing it. Yeah, something like this. Yeah, it's probably wrong. I think it's okay. Let's draw the other one. Oh yes, we have the little hole here. Krivis? I don't know the name of this thing. So let's try to use the Seraphis too. So let's check some things. Yeah, the handle more or less ends here. It kind of ends here. Yeah. It looks very wrong. Yeah, yeah. So, my first stream and my first failure. That's okay. Let's try to draw the rest of the handle here to try to understand what's going on. Yes, but it's more inclined. And that's what's making it hard for me. It's a complicated and inclined shape. I think it's making more sense, no? Let's try to draw this here. Like this, maybe drawing the little marks here will help. Okay, this is wrong too, it's wider at the top. That's it, kind of. It's kind of wrong, but hey, that's cool. So, I don't know how, what these things are called. The little spots below the pen. I'm going to draw them a little bit. I think they add a nice perspective to the drawing. This, go like this. That's a common mistake. This line here is parallel to this line. So you should try to get them parallel, of course, respecting perspective, but it's almost quite parallel. Yeah, I think that's okay. That's probably wrong, but let's continue. We have the first one. Second one, and below here we have the fire. So you just, let's draw an ellipsis. Try to make your ellipses symmetrical. Kind of have our fire here. still not satisfied with these handles. They are not very good, not good at all. They're a little bit more complicated than I had anticipated. Let's try to do this. What I am seeing here. Things are getting quite confusing, aren't they? Oh, that's just a sketch. Okay, that's it. I'm bored with these things. So what I'm going to do now is start a new layer. Let's call it line art. Line art. Let's call it refined. I'm going to lower the opacity of the sketch layer and change my brush color to let's go with a dark kind of brown. Yeah, that's okay. I'm going to change my pencil to this one. And let's begin to refine our forms. We have the sketch to use as a basis and have our reference. And now that I'm noticing the pen is taller than the reference. But let it be. Okay, let's continue. I'm not going to do anything. Okay, so here we have a problem. I am the right layer. Why am I not drawing? Oh yes, I clicked the eraser. That happens to me a lot. Let's begin to refining our shape. Just a second. So let's begin. What I did wrong? Okay. Thank you. So this thing is quite important. A very common beginner's mistake is to draw something like this. Let's say I'm drawing a cylinder. Now, the correct way to draw a cylinder is to use ellipses. And what you have at the where the sides meet the bottom is a very smooth transition. Lots of beginners make the mistake of drawing something like this. See? A very abrupt transition here. This is wrong. This is the right way to draw a cylinder. And that's what I'm trying to do right here. So let's undo a little explanation here. Let's take a look at my reference, see if my ellipsis is okay. It seems to be. Alright. So the rest of it, it's quite dark there. I have a little trouble seeing where one thing ends or another starts, but I think it's something like this. So what I did wrong there, it's quite simple. My ellipsis was asymmetrical. I'm going to try to fix this now. Maybe draw a little dots. Maybe it will help. Let's see. I think that's much better now. Our magnification. I think that's okay for the handle. Let's draw the... What's the name of the thing that goes above the pen? Forgot. As you can see, my English is not very good. So you may ask, if I'm so bad at English, why am I doing my stream on English? Well, that's simple. Wider audience. Let's draw like this. Okay, so... Okay. I'm going to draw ellipses. Cover. Is it cover? I think it's cover. Pen cover. No, that doesn't sound right for me. I have this problem. When I listen to a word in English, I know what it means. But somehow, when I'm going to speak in English, I cannot remember the words to use, even though I know the words. Okay, so here. So we cannot quite see it because the thing is made of glass. But it comes more or less like this. I think.
Okay, so we have the bard here. Okay, that goes like this. It has a little bit of height here. Let's try to draw this. And here we have the pen. Yes, here we have the bottom. Little curve here. And it goes like this. It seems okay to me. So let's try to draw this here. You can see that I am avoiding the handles. The handles will be quite a problem. So let's draw other things for now. Have a little curve here, perspective here. It comes kind of like this. Just to do the same thing here, kind of. Decrease the magnification a little bit. This side here. This side here. This side here. Yeah, I know, they were supposed to be straight, but hey, I suck, so they're not so straight. This, behind the pen, kind of goes like this. Yeah, no. Like this. Okay, let's draw a fire. Yes. So if you look here, I cannot see the entire top of the fire thing. And here I can see. What this means? This means that I made a mistake. Eraser. Let's erase stuff. Fixes. Looks a bit wrong, but I think that's more or less how it is. My pen is not in the center here of the fire thing. Is it? Yeah. It doesn't seem to be in the center of the fire thing in the reference either. Okay, so let's save. I forgot to save what I'm drawing. This is very important to save things. Let's plow it. Today is 17th. No, forget about it. 2020. For 17 space pen. Save. So now let's face my arch nemesis. The handles. Well, the handles are kind of this flattened cylinder here. They come like this, and they come like this. Okay, that was the easy part. Now let's go to the hard part. Okay, and I am wrong in the easy part too. Things should go more like this. Okay. Yeah, more like this. So my first problem is that I cannot understand how this thing... What? Is the shape of this thing. I think it kind of goes like this. The bottom, and then it curves like this. Here, and it goes like this. Why this part is kind of like here. And it has a little height here. It's a little hole. That's it. The problem is how to draw this thing, this abomination in the other side. This line's wrong. It's this line here that I want to follow. And this line here. Okay. Still looks quite wrong for me. I think it's a little bit better. Yes.
See, I should have fixed this on the sketch, not the fine thing. But hey, you need to be free, creative on your stuff. No.
Nah.
I think it's okay. So let's save. Now I'm going to create a new layer. Let's call this. Increase the opacity of the refine layer. Make the sketch layer invisible. Line art. How am I going to do my line art? Should I use a pen? Let's try to use a pen. Yeah, it will suck, but hey, let's try. So now I'm going to use black. I'm on the line art layer, and I'm going to do my final line drawing. So this that I'm doing here is wrong. You should not do this. You should try to do a beautiful single stroke. Like, let's say something like this. See? But I'm not good enough to do these kinds of things. Maybe if I increase a little bit the size of the pen, it would be a little bit easier. Let's see what easier I did here. Drink a little water. Let's use a pencil. If later I decide to shape this drawing, the pencil will be better for me to shade, to blend with the shade. See? Yeah, I think it's better. No. One thing that you can do using Krita is cheating. If you, like me, don't have enough coordination to draw the lines correctly, you can use a stabilizer. What the stabilizer does is give you a lot of time to draw your lines exactly the way you want them to draw them. See, look at this beautiful line here. See? Who needs to develop their fine motor skills? You can just use a stabilizer. So the objective here is to learn. So let's avoid cheating for now, at least. So raise. Pencil. Here. I need to increase the size of the pencil a little bit. Let's go. I think too much. Yeah, it's better. So let's look at our reference.
Yeah, okay. And doing your final line art, the undo control Z function hits your frame. So here we have our border here. Seems like stainless steel. It's wrong, but okay, let's go. Okay. So border here is a little bit tricky because it's kind of a cylinder. So you don't have a very precise notion of when the border starts, what is the top and what's the side of the borders. That's okay. Eraser here. Pen. So where's my pencils? Pencils here. To handle. But okay. Let's go here. Wrong. Skip the handles for now. Kind of like this. Straight It would be better to draw the line very fast here, but I really don't have the necessary coordination to do it correctly. No. 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 Yeah, kind of. No. Yeah. Okay. Let's mask it a little bit. Razor. Raise. Pencil. Here. Oh yes, the handles. These things are a nightmare. This one, and what I'm going to do about this monstrosity here. This. Then, let's take a look at the reference. Oh god, it sucks so much. Okay. Let's save. Oh yeah, it sucks. Let's see the pen in its full glory. Oh yes, it's magnificent.
It's okay. So this was a ban. Let's save it again. And start a new drawing. Your file. This template. So let's see what I'm going to draw now. Kitchen utensils. What's another interesting kitchen utensil that we can draw? This scale sounds okay, but I would like something with a more interesting perspective. Next page. The scale is free download. So here we have it, a kitchen scale. Let's try to draw it. So again, let's create our sketch later. Let's use this pencil, color blue. Okay, so the scale is quite symmetrical. So let's begin. So our scale is quite symmetrical, so let's start drawing. Send the line of symmetry here. Let's try to do something a little quicker now. So breaking down the scaling. Let's first try to get the overall proportions of the scale right. So here's the top. Let's increase a little bit to size of our pencil. this, this. Yeah, I think it's more or less like this. And here's the bottom. So the center of our, what's the name of this thing? Dial? Not a dial. The thing that you read to know how much the thing weighs. Yes, it's about 2/3 of the way down. So if you divide the triscale more or less like 3 parts, I think that the center of the dial is more or less here, and it goes more or less like this. Am I right? Am I wrong? I don't know. Let's find out. So it's a simple circle. Let's draw a circle here as best as we can. Have our circle, and then it comes like this. Then this. Then have the base here. Base is here, and we can see a little bit of perspective here with the base. Here, then kind of ending there. Okay, let's maybe it's a little bit bigger. So this is interesting. It seems to me that the horizon line is exactly here. So if you think of this as a box, the horizon line is here. So you can see, cannot see the bottom of the box, it's here. And you cannot see the top of the box. They all kind of disappear here. No, because the horizon line is here, this part of the bow is not perfectly straight, it has a little curve. A little curve, not too much. Okay.
is a little mistake here. Bezo?
Okay.
So here's our first sketch. The kitchen scale. Let's go to the refinement layer. It's probably wrong, but okay. Decrease the opacity of the sketch layer. Let's use this pencil. Let's use this color. It's working. Let's refine our lines. This scale is a little bit crooked, isn't it?
Drawing circles is hard.
Especially big ones. Okay. It's all right. Okay, so I drew a line of symmetry, so let's try to use it. Center. So this here. Oh, this is a problem. We have a bunch of concentric circles. This is not going to end up well. Usually, you would use a compass or a guide to draw these things, but I'm trying to develop a better coordination. So I'm going to freehand everything. Okay. Now this one.
Yeah.
Okay. Top part. Yeah. Right on the horizon line. Move the supports of the bow. Okay, completely asymmetrical. Let's pay more attention to what I'm doing. Okay, this one's better. A little thing here, a little knot. Always try to draw the lips. That's it. Let's pointer here. It's a little bit wider. Okay. All right. There's a little detail here. Okay, okay. So let's add a new layer. Call it liner. So with line art, I'm going to cheat a little bit and use guides. So use guides in Krita, you just come here on what's the name of this thing? And ellipses. And then you draw your ellipse. Is there a circle?
Is there
there's one thing I think Krita could do better is the whole guide system. It's a little bit annoying.
Oh, the concentric ellipsis is better. Forgot to turn on the snap to assist. Here we go.
Oh yes, here we have it. Perfect ellipse. Oh, it's circle. Perfect circle. But all circles are ellipses too. So I'm not completely wrong. Here we have the bowl. Oh, it's a little bit of smash poison. Oh, I'm using so thick of a line. It's a little bit better now. Here. Draw the lips, always draw the lips. It's all right. Let's Cancel. Oh yes, I completely misjudged the diameter of this inner circle here. That's okay. Let's erase here. The numbers. How are you going to draw this? So use this, and I'm going to use a much finer. Yes. Let's try it here. Let's go 2000. Yeah, I'm not a great calligrapher, I know. For the letters. Astro Black Classic. Let's just write Classic here.
guess. Forgot about this thing here. Erase our line here. Here. Here we have it. Our kitchen scale. Let's draw this last line here. Here we have it, our kitchen scale. Same. Never know what are the correct gestures here. No, another P. Today is a 17. Yeah, today it is. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for everybody watching. I am Kage, and this is Drawing with Kage. Thank you very much. Till next time.